If there's a place that has not been reached, people that have not been served, if there is a calamity or need, that is where Operation Blessing is ready to go. From the Batanes Islands in the north to the Isles of Palawan in the west, eastward to the Catanduanes Islands, all the way down to Basilan, Sulu, and Tawi-Tawi. Thousands of volunteers have rushed over at great personal sacrifice, risking their lives, enduring the roughest conditions, entering war zones and terrorist strongholds. In June 2000, a medical and disaster relief team camped close to the rebel stronghold of Abubakar in Maguindanao to bring food, medicines, and a message of peace. In Davao Oriental, OB volunteers from local and ruling families asked forgiveness for any prejudice and hostility towards our Muslim brethren. With warm embraces, centuries of antagonism and mistrust were broken down. Thanks to missions like these, Operation Blessing twice won the NGO of the Year for Peace Efforts Awards given by the Armed Forces of the Philippines in 2002 and 2003. The awards were personally handed over by the President of the Philippines, the Commander-in-Chief. This significantly marks a long-standing partnership between Operation Blessing and the military. Since Operation Blessing Philippines was legally launched as a foundation in 1996, it has intensified its efforts to make Filipinos productive and self-sustaining. Hundreds of the unemployed, including former scavengers and rebel returnees, have been given skills in hydroponics, appliance repair, basket weaving, soap making, and more through its mobile and out-of-school training program. This former drug addict and pusher is smiling. He graduated with honors in a course in refrigerator repair, and his two children are back in school through Operation Blessing's Bless a Child program. The future generation is a major concern and priority of Operation Blessing. Thousands of children all over the country have been helped by its Bless a Child feeding and education program through medical aid, circumcision, deworming, and other services. These golden agers have found a new lease in life thanks to free cataract surgeries in partnership with the Asian Eye Institute. Hundreds of villagers have also been revived through Operation Blessing's Community Transformation Program. Families have been given carabaos, pigs, rice and corn to help them start farms and share with the rest of the village. OB conducts health seminars, family Bible counseling, financial management training, including the startup of cooperatives. Operation Blessing helps set the foundation for other OB missions around Asia, sharing its experience and expertise in medical missions and disaster relief abroad, to challenge villages in India, to the elderly and disabled in China, to earthquake-stricken Taiwan, to poverty-ridden communities in Vietnam, Laos, Cambodia, and Thailand, and several times to devastated Iraq, war-torn Afghanistan, and tsunami-battered Indonesia. Yet with all the work that has been accomplished, there are countless communities that still await our Savior's touch of hope. Operation Blessing, networking with churches, local governments, other Christian ministries, and selfless individuals like yourself, have committed to continue the task at hand. Together, let us persist in giving of ourselves, bringing the nation into the endless cycle of God's blessing.